Children, hope you all are fine. So let's begin today's class. Class 5 maths lesson number 1 is continued. Here you can see the question of exercise 1.3. Next questions. You have seen the question of exercise 1.3. The question number 1 deals with the fill in the blanks, that is comparing the numbers. How can we compare a number? By using smaller than, greater than or equal to symbol. So the first question there is 3,86,49,586 has to be compared with another number 4,86,49,586. So we shall start comparing from the beginning of the number or from the left side. So we will compare 3 and we will compare 4. So 3 is less than 4, less than, greater than or equal to. 3 is less than 4. So the total number is less than the next number. Similarly, the next question, 1,40,004 and 1,30,003. We will start comparing from the again from the left side end. That is, here 1 is there, here also 1 is there. Both zeros are there here. In lakh place again zeros are there. In thousands place we have 40 and we have 30. So we will compare 40 and 30. As till this much, till the lakhs place, as it is same, we are not going to compare this till the lakh. Then we'll compare the thousands place. That is, we'll compare 40 and 30. So 40 is less than or greater than or equal to 30. It is greater than 30. So we will use the symbol greater than. I hope you understood the question number 1, how to compare the numbers. Next, we'll go for the ascending order, the question number B. What is ascending order? Ascending order means arrangement of the numbers from the smallest to the large number or the largest number. So we will see the which is the smallest number, then we will compare with the other numbers. How we will know which is the smallest number or greatest number or larger number? We will count all the digits present in every number. So let's start. So the number of digits present in the first number, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. How many digits are there here? 8 digits. The next number, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. How many digits are there? 9. Next number, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. How many digits? 7 digits. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. How many digits? 9 digits are there. So simply if I'll tell you to arrange this all numbers of digits, then how shall you arrange it from smallest to the largest one? First you will say it as 7, then 8, then comes 9 and again 9. So the always the numbers of digits you will count and we will find out the smallest one to arrange in the ascending order. The first number will be in the sequence will be a 38,54,798. Next, which next number comes? The number of which is having 8 digits. So this is the next number. So it is 3,85,47,986. Now comes both the 9 digit numbers. So how shall we compare? We have already studied how to compare two numbers. So we'll start from again from the left side. 38, both are in the crores place, they are same. 54 in the lakhs place are same. 79 and 79 in the thousands place are same. The only difference is 860 and 850. So 860 is greater than 850. So we shall use the number of 9 digit number, this one, as the next number. So it is 38,54,79,850. Which number is left out? This one. So this is the last, the greatest number over when you compare all the numbers. So 38,54,79,860. Similarly, we will go for the C number question. That is your descending order. Descending order means arranging your numbers from the bigger number or the greatest number to the smallest number or the least number. Use the same rules whatever we have used for the ascending order, and you can carry forward for the descending order. Next question, question number D. Write down the following greatest 7-digit number. When we say 7-digit number, for the easiest one, how to do it is just put 7 dashes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Greatest it is given. So, when it is given a greatest one, then we will repeat the 9 7 times. Greatest 7-digit number. That means 7 times we will repeat 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Similarly, for the smallest 8-digit number, again we shall put it 8 dashes, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. When it is told smallest, always remember children, it will always start with your 1 and the other dashes will be your 0. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. 1 is the initial one and there are 7 number of zeros. So, this too, I hope you can do it. Question number E. Circle the smallest and tick the largest number in each group. So, in each group, you have to find it out which is your smallest one. That you have to circle it, and the largest one you have to tick it. So, how to compare the numbers? We have already studied in question number A, B, C. How to compare and find it out which is the smallest and which is the largest. So, let's compare and find it out. When you compare all these numbers, which is the smallest number here? 5,67,345 is the smallest one. And which is the greatest one or the largest number? When you compare, just see the numbers by which we can find it out. We have to count the number of digits. So, as you have done all these questions previously, by looking at the numbers, we can know which is the largest number. So, it is 3,94,25,060 is the largest number. So, we will not circle this. We will tick this one. Similarly, in the next question, also numbers are given and we have to find it out which is the smallest one. We have to circle it, and the largest one or the greatest one, we have to just simply to tick it. Next, going to the question number F. Use the following digits to write the smallest and the greatest number you can form. Use each digit only once. See, it is given here, use each digit only once. That means no repetition. Another instruction is given to you, the number should not start with 0. The number should not start with 0. When you include 0, we have already studied in the previous class, it will not be included in as a digit when we count the number of digit. If it is a 7-digit number or 8-digit number or 9-digit number, the number never should be started with 0. It will become the next junior digit number or the next smallest digit number. So, the question number F. Bit number 1, the digits given are 3, 4, 6, 0, 9, 8. To form the smallest number, we shall start arranging in the ascending order. And for the greatest number, we shall start arranging from the biggest number. Like for the smallest number, we can start with 0. But we will not start with 0, we will start with 3. 3, 0, then 4, then 6. Then 8, then 9. For the largest digit number, we will just do the reverse one, that is descending order. Now we can start with, the largest digit is your 9. So we'll start with 9, 8, 6, 4, 3 and 0. 0 can be used at the last place or the ones place, but it cannot be used at the first in the left side corner. Or the starting of the digits or the numbers. Similarly, all the in every question you can find a 0. So be careful while forming the numbers of the smallest and the greatest number. I mean the question number G. Use the given digit to form the smallest and greatest numbers of the number of given digits written after each. Here it is clearly instructed how many digit numbers will you create, whether it is 6 digit, whether it is a 7 digit, whether it is a 8 digit, or whether it is a 9 digit. It is already mentioned. The first instruction was given like that. The second instruction is repeat digits as necessary. Here the next instruction given to you is repeat the digits as it is necessary. So we are going to follow these two rules and we are going to find it out the answers. So the first question here is question number G. Bit number 1 is the digits that are given are 6, 0, 9 and 8. And you have to form a 6 digit number. Question number G. And the instruction is given, we can repeat it. We can repeat the numbers. So we have to form a 6 digit. What I have told in the previous classes, whenever some digits are given like this, a 6 digit or 7 digit or 8 digit, better to put some dashes. So 6 digit is given. Let me put 6 dashes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Are there 6 digits here? No. Only we have 4 digits. So we can repeat the digits as it is instructed. So to form a smallest number, smallest 6 digit number, we will start with the smallest one. Which is the smallest one? 6. Which is the largest one? 9. So we can place it in the ones place. Which is the smallest 2, 9? It is 8. What is left here is 0. When we repeat 0, then it will become a smallest 6 digit number. If we repeat 8, it will not become a smallest 6 digit number. If we repeat 6 also, it will also not become a smallest 6 digit number. Let's see, if we repeat 6, will it become a smallest? No. If we repeat 8, will it become a smallest? No. I repeated 8 here. Will it be a right one? No. This is also a wrong number. So we are, for the smallest 6 digit number, when the instruction is given here to repeat it, then only repeat the smallest digit among the digit that are given to you. Right? Then to find the greatest digit, greatest 6 digit number. Greatest 6 digit number, the same rule as the smallest one. Here in the smallest one, we are going to repeat the smallest digit. And in the greatest one, we are going to repeat the greatest digit. Which is the greatest digit? Before that, what shall we do? If it is given 6 digit number, we will put 6 dashes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So, which among these 4 digits, which is the greatest digit? 9. Which is the smallest digit? 0. Greater to 0 is 6. Greater to 6 is 8. So we have already arranged. How many dashes are there here? 2. 2 more. So 9 and 9. As I told, we should repeat only the greatest digit that is present in the given digits here. So now it will become your greatest 6 digit number formation by the given digits to you. Question number 2, 3 and 4 is related with the 7 digit, 8 digit and 9 digit. I hope you can do it. Here are the answers for exercise 1.3. You can just check your answers after doing. Till then, thank you. Take care and bye.